folks, welcome to CodeCrux. This is Mahesh Guhani, and in this video, I'm going to talk about design of fuzzy logic controller. The points I'm going to cover in this video would be a fuzzy control system, types of various fuzzy control systems, the steps to implement fuzzy logic controller, and we'll see one example at the end. The application of fuzzy logic control extends from individual process control to controlling very complex processes like biomedical instrumentation or various type of security systems. A control system is an arrangement of physical components such that it will alter the behavior of some other physical system, such that that other physical system will exhibit the desired characteristics. Basically, there are two types of fuzzy control systems: open loop fuzzy control system and closed loop fuzzy control system. In open loop fuzzy control system, the input control action is independent of the physical system's output. That is, the output produced by the system will not affect the input parameters of the system. That means there is absence of a feedback system. The example of open loop control system is washing machine. Once you set the input parameters like temperature of the water, duration of the program, RPM of the machine, and once you instruct the controller to wash the clothes, so independent of whatever was the quality of the washed cloth, it will not alter the input parameter next time. So this is considered as an open loop control system. So it will simply read the inputs, it will be given to the controller, and controller will take the action and it will simply produce the output. Designing such system is a bit simpler because there is nothing like a feedback mechanism and it does not require to tune the input parameters next time. In closed loop control system, the new output of the physical system depends on the previous output of the system. It means, depending upon what was the output previous time, the new parameters will be tuned, some new rules will be fired, and controller will take some new actions. So, air conditioner is an example of closed loop control system. Depending upon external parameters like whether door is open or not, what is the volume of this room, how many people are present at a time, what is the temperature inside, what is the temperature outside, etc., it will try to optimize its internal parameter. So this all factors might be changing. Number of person may increase or decrease over the time. Sometimes door might be open or maybe closed for some time. So depending upon that, the internal parameters of the fuzzy systems will be adjusted and some new output will be generated every time. So the temperature might be increased or decreased by the air conditioner controller. So this is a kind of closed loop control system. So closed loop control system is having a feedback mechanism. So whatever output is generated is given back to the system and it will tune the parameters. Advantages of fuzzy logic control system is that they are quite cheaper as well as they are robust because they can easily handle the imprecision into the data. They are customizable. You can design your own fuzzy membership functions. You can determine the range of your own fuzzy subsets, and according to that, it's a fine-tunable. Fuzzy logic works just like a human thinking process, and it is reliable and efficient. So even there is some variability into input parameters, it can sustain. The disadvantage is that it requires a lot of knowledge because the success of the system depends on the design of knowledge base. And for the designing of knowledge base, we required a lot of inputs from the experts of that particular domain. And we also needed to update the rules into the system regularly. Applications of the fuzzy control system spans over a very big spectrum. It includes traffic control systems, aircraft flight control systems, steam engine system, elevator control system is also designed with fuzzy logic controller, various home appliances like air conditioner, washing machine, microwave oven, they all are using fuzzy logic controller. Robot navigation can also be implemented very effectively with the help of fuzzy control system. And the list of applications of fuzzy logic controller is quite big. These are some of the main applications of FLC. Now we'll see the step-by-step procedure for designing any fuzzy logic controller. And in a later half, we will discuss it with the example. So the first step is that we need to identify variables for the given system. So we need to find out what are the input parameters and what are the output parameters for any given system. In step two, we should find out a proper fuzzy subsets. So the universe of information spanned by each variable is divided in small sets, and each set is given some linguistic variable name. For example, the entire range of temperature might be divided into low temperature, medium temperature, and high temperature. Next, we need to obtain the membership function for all these subsets. So whatever subsets we have created, like low, medium, high, etc., we have to mathematically formulate them so that given any value of temperature, we can find out appropriate fuzzy value for that, or we can find out the membership value of that input into given fuzzy subset. Next step is to design a fuzzy rule base. Here, the role of domain expert is quite important because the success of entire fuzzy inference system is heavily depending on the design of this rule base. So it is nothing but it's a combination of input parameters, and depending upon to the values of input parameters, what actions should be taken, that is determined by the fuzzy rule base. Next step is to normalize and scale the parameters. This is optional step, but if our parameters are having very big difference in their magnitude, that is some parameter is in range of 10 and some parameter is in range of thousands, then we might need to apply normalization or scaling to that, such that the range of parameters will fall within 0 to 1 or maybe between minus 1 to plus 1, depending upon what normalization technique we are using. After that, whatever inputs are given or the crisp value for the inputs are given, we have to apply fuzzification on that and we have to convert it into the fuzzy value so that fuzzy inference system can interpret that way. The next step is to identify the output. So with the help of fuzzy rule base, the fuzzy inference system will read the fuzzy input, will apply some process, and it will generate some fuzzy output. And the last step is the defuzzification process. So whatever fuzzy output is generated, we need to convert it into crisp value so that controller can take appropriate actions. We already have studied a few defuzzification methods in previous videos. The link is given in the description box. You can refer them to clear your concepts for defuzzification. Let us try to understand all these steps with the help of an example. Assume that we have to design a fuzzy logic controller for the steam turbine. We are given the inputs like a temperature and pressure. Based on the values of temperature and pressure, we have to control the throttle setting of the steam turbine. So that is the expected output. It is also given that we have to divide the range of input parameters into three different fuzzy subsets and the range of output parameter into five different fuzzy subsets. So the first step is the identification of the variables. So from definition or the description of the problem, it is quite clear that input parameters are temperature and pressure, and the output variable is throttle setting of the steam turbine. Step 2 is the fuzzy subset configuration. It means the range of entire temperature or the pressure or the throttle setting, we have to divide it into number of parts or the number of fuzzy subsets. As instructed into the description of the problem, range of input parameters will be divided into 3 parts and the range of output parameter will be divided into 5 parts. So assume that temperature takes cool, nominal, and warm fuzzy subset. Pressure is represented by low, okay, and strong fuzzy subsets. Whereas the output variable throttle setting is having 5 different fuzzy subsets. Let us call it as a N2, which represents large negative, N1, that is small negative, Z indicates 0, P1 corresponds to small positive, and P2 corresponds to large positive. So this is what a fuzzy subset construction for entire universe of the variables. In next step, we have to derive a membership functions for each of these fuzzy subset. So assume that we are given the range of temperature from 0 to 40. We are dividing this range into 3 subsets, cool, nominal, and warm. Assume that the range of cool varies from 0 to 20 degree, nominal spans from 0 to 40, and warm set spans from 20 to 40 degree. So given any temperature value xt, we should be able to identify the membership value of that temperature in corresponding fuzzy set. Using the formula y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1 is equal to y minus y1 upon x minus x1, we will be able to identify the corresponding y value for any given xt or the input parameter x. As can be seen from the diagram, the membership value in cool class decreases as temperature increases, and that's quite obvious. At temperature xt is equal to 20, the membership value will become 0 in cool class. So we can define the membership function for cool class like this. For this cool class, x1 y1 is 0, 1 and x2 y2 is 20, 0. By putting appropriate values in the given equation, we will get mu cool is equal to 20 minus xt upon 20. In this equation, this x represents input from this xt axis and y corresponds to membership value corresponding to that x in cool class. So we are simply changing the variable names y to mu cool and x to xt, and that conventions will be following throughout the discussion. Nominal class or nominal subset is not monotonically increasing or decreasing. It is increasing for the temperature range from 0 to 20, and from 20 to 40 it is decreasing. So we have to find out a fuzzy membership functions for both the halves. From 0 to 20 range, x1 y1 would be 0, 0 and x2 y2 would be 20, 1. So if we put all these values, then we will get mu is equal to xt by 20. For the another half, that is for xt is equal to 20 to 40, the x1 y1 corresponds to 20, 1 and x2 y2 corresponds to 40, 0. When you put all these values, we will get membership value as 40 minus xt divided by 20. If we combine both these membership values, we can club that into single functions, and that is represented as membership value in nominal class is given by xt upon 20 if temperature range is between 0 to 20, and it is 40 minus xt by 20 if temperature range is between 20 to 40. So using this single equation, we can compute the membership value of any temperature in nominal class. And for the warm class, as we move from 20 degree to 40 degree, membership is increasing. The x1 y1 for this warm class would be 20, 0 and x2 y2 would be 40, 1. So when we put all these values in the equation and when we solve this, we will get mu warm is equal to xt minus 20 divided by 20. In identical way, we can compute the fuzzy membership functions for the pressure. So xp represents the pressure axis. Low, OK and strong corresponds to three fuzzy subsets we have created for this pressure range. And assume that pressure ranges from 0 to 100 degree. So mu low, mu OK and mu strong we can compute in the identical manner just we computed it for the temperature. And in similar way, we can compute the membership values for the output parameter. That is mu N2, mu N1, mu Z, mu P1 and mu P2. The equation for all these membership functions are described here. Next step is to design a rule base. We have three possibilities for input temperature and three possibilities for input pressure. So we will have total 9 rules that will take combinations of temperature and pressure. To fill this value, we required help of the domain expert. So according to his experience and the observations, we should put values here from the output parameters that varies from N2, N1, Z, P1 to P2. So if these values are not kept properly, then there are chances that your system might not be accurate. And that's why the role of domain expert is quite important in designing fuzzy rule base. Assume that the current temperature is 30% and the pressure is 40% of its entire range. And we have to compute the corresponding throttle settings. So range of temperature varies from 0 to 40. So 30% of the temperature would be 12. Now we have to find out where this 12 belongs to and what is the membership value of 12. So xt is equal to 12 belongs to fuzzy set cool as well as nominal with some different membership values. We already have derived membership functions for all these three. So if we simply put the value xt is equal to 12 in equation of mu cool, we will get the membership value of temperature 12 degree in cool fuzzy set, which is 2 by 5. And if we put xt is equal to 12 in equation of mu nominal, we will get the membership value mu nominal as a 3 by 5. The range of pressure is from 0 to 100 and we have to consider the 40% of the current pressure. So 40% of this would be 40 units. So for xp is equal to 40, we have to find out where this value belongs to. So xp is equal to 40 belongs to fuzzy set low as well as OK. Again, we already know the equations for mu low and mu OK. If we put xp is equal to 40 in both the equations, we will get appropriate membership value of XP is equal to 40 for both the fuzzy sets. That will get mu low is equal to 1 by 5 and mu ok as 4 by 5. As we know from the previous slide, the temperature belongs to set cool and nominal, and pressure belongs to set low and ok. There are two variables for temperature and two variables for pressure. So if we take the combination of both, we will get total four different rules. Like rule 1 says that temperature is cool, pressure is low. Rule 2 says that temperature is cool, pressure is okay, and so on. We can write down all the rules. And the rule base for that, or the actions taken for that, would look like this. If temperature is cool and pressure is low, then action taken will be P2, that means large positive rotation of the throttle. And similar way, we can construct all the following rules. So these are the four rules we can construct from the given fuzzy rule base. The rule 1 says that if temperature is cool and pressure is low, then action taken by the controller would be throttle setting is equal to P2. Second rule says if temperature is cool and pressure is okay, then throttle setting should be 0. And in similar way, we can derive all four rules. Now we have to find out the strength of individual rule, and then we'll use that for computing the output. So rule 1 says that temperature is cool. So temperature has membership value 2 by 5 in the cool set. Second half says that pressure is low. So pressure has membership value 1 by 5 in the low fuzzy set. Both the part of this antecedent are connected using AND connectives. So to compute the final membership value, we have to take the minimum membership value. So out of this 2 by 5 and 1 by 5, 1 by 5 is the minimum. And the control action is throttle setting is P2. So P2 will take membership value 1 by 5, which is depicted in this diagram. Rule 2 says temperature is cool and pressure is okay. So temperature has membership value 2 by 5 in cool set, and pressure has membership value 4 by 5 in the okay set. So if we take intersection of these two, it will return the minimum membership value, that is 2 by 5, and the action taken is to be performed Z. So membership value of Z is determined by the minimum membership value of temperature is cool and pressure is okay, which is 2 by 5. So the area covered by the fuzzy output set Z would be as shown here, which is highlighted in green. Similarly, the rule 3 says if temperature is nominal and pressure is low, so temperature has membership value 3 by 5 in nominal set, and pressure has membership value 1 by 5 in a low set. So minimum membership value of these two would be 1 by 5, and the control action to be taken is in P2 set. So it is already computed and it is identical to the rule 1 itself. So there won't be any update into the area. And rule 4 says that temperature is nominal and pressure is okay. So membership value of temperature in nominal is 3 by 5, and membership value of pressure in okay set is 4 by 5. So minimum out of this is 4 by 5, and the corresponding fuzzy output set is Z. So Z will be updated as shown here. So all four rules are fired. Corresponding areas spanned by all these four rules are also computed, and they are also shown graphically. We have to use the aggregated area for computing the output. This is what aggregated fuzzy output function. We can apply various defuzzification methods on this, and we can compute the final crisp value corresponding to 30% of temperature and 40% of pressure. We are using here weighted average method. So for that, we need to find out center of both the fuzzy functions. So center of first polygon is 0, and center of second polygon is 67.93, and corresponding membership values are 3 by 5 and 1 by 5. If we put all these value in the given equation and we solve it, we will get the crisp value 16.98 degree. So the throttle setting should be done by 16.984 degree. So this is how we can design any control system. So steps are quite straightforward as discussed earlier. So we simply have to follow those steps, apply the concepts we have learned so far step by step, and we will be able to derive crisp output corresponding to given any crisp input. That's it for today, folks. See you in next video. If you think this video was useful to you, then please like, comment and share. Don't forget to subscribe the channel CodeCracks. Press the bell icon for the notification of latest videos. Stay connected, stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.